How do we turn this from a design into a reality?
We spoke with lead resident engineer Tiffany Wang and engineering team leader Allaire O'Connor. They've worked together for years.
We met, I went to a meeting at Prospect Park.
Yeah, before I was at the agency. I remember very clearly. It was on the path behind the Litchfield Villa.
On all sorts of projects.
Reconstruction of buildings, new buildings.
Stabilization of buildings. Nettings in existing buildings.
Roofing, the fire tower in Harlem.
A lot of waterfront sinkholes. Rehab.
We joined them in Red Hook to learn a bit more about their work that we might not see.
The largest work task here was stripping all of the contaminated soil, stockpiling it for testing and removal to the proper facilities. And then we come in with a demarcation layer, clean fill, and then depending on what type of field is on top, it's the base, the drainage layer for that field, and then the track material or the synthetic turf for the fields. You know, it just looks like a lot of large, giant fields, but it's been a lot of work that goes into underneath them and a lot of coordination that goes on with other agencies and within the agency itself.
I came on to cover for Allaire while she was on maternity leave. My family lives in this area. My nephew actually goes to school right across the street. So it's nice to hear when we return Fall Fields 5 through 8, how they were able to get it on a daily basis. We're standing here on what will be the track. Stuff that will be underground will be a giant pipe right through the middle down the site to connect out towards the water.
On a typical project, a decent percentage of the project is underground that most people don't see, but in Red Hook in general is probably almost 50% of the project because of the amount of soil that we removed from the contamination levels and then the amount of clean soil that had to go in to build it back up.
And then the drainage, the utilities, combined sewer outflow.
Parts of Red Hook were raised in general to meet the new resiliency standards. So we elevated different portions of the park to be above flood levels. It's really hard to see how much work goes into building a field, the layers that go underneath the field and everything that goes into bringing this to life.
I didn't know there was that many layers of turf. I thought it was turf, right? Turf, the little black things in your shoes, right? There's more to it.
Yeah.
Surprise.
The turf is put in by a turf crew that's very specialty. And they literally come out with just a large sewing machine and they sew the long seams of the turf together.
There's a lot to the job. It's not just, you know, somebody that could just be one type. You have to be flexible. You have to be open to new ideas.
I think there's a lot of opportunity at the agency. You know, if you work hard and you're willing to get involved and put the effort in, there's definitely a growth ladder here.
Came to Parks as a resident engineer, have been a construction project manager title and into the lead resident engineer role, which I am right now.
It's cool to drive by something or go somewhere and say, like, I was a part of this, like, I helped build this or I helped design this. It's cool to see something so large and physical finally come to life that you were a part of, even if you're just a small part of it.